Hello everybody, my name is Gil Westmeyer. We are here at the Helmholtz Zentrum in Munich. And I wanted to quickly introduce you today, NeuBtracker, a neurobehavioral tracking microscope that we use to simultaneously look at the brain activity and the behavior of freely swimming zebrafish larvae, an important genetic model organism for biomedical research. To give you an idea of the scales involved, I'm holding here a little swimming arena that has a central divider, and you might picture the size of the larvae swimming in this arena to be about an exclamation mark on a printed page. Now we position this arena filled with water and larvae swimming in it in the center of this instrument, and there is a camera on top that it is keeping track of the position of the animal and recording the behavior. And the position is then passed on to a mirror system, a galvanometric mirror system located at the upper left of the instrument. And that mirror system ensures that the field of view of a fluorescent camera is always centered around the brain of the animal, such that we can there observe what's going on. Now, in conjunction with genetic reporter lines, such as calcium indicator lines, that express a fluorescent calcium indicator protein in certain neurons of the larval brain, we can then see changes in that fluorescent signal, or changes in brain activity, as this animal is freely exploring the arena. And you might appreciate some of these recordings here in the background that we looked at in the context, for instance, of orientation behaviors towards attractive stimuli or away from a repulsive odorants like cadaverine. Another natural line of research that one might be interested in conducting with such an instrument is to screen neuroactive drugs with respect to their combined effects on brain activity and behavior of these larvae. And since everything already happens in water, this is quite convenient as we can just dispense these pharmacological agents into multi-well plates that we can move around with motorized stages, as an example, and thereby do high throughput screening of these neuroactive drugs. So if you're interested in also looking into neurobehavioral imaging in zebrafish larvae, I invite you to visit neuBtracker.org. It is a little website we put up that accompanies our first publication on the matter by some leaders and colleagues, and it holds blueprints of the different designs as well as code to control the instrument and acquire data. And please visit us there and also email us about it so that we can maybe foster neurobehavioral image in also other laboratories in the world. Thank you very much indeed.